Dennis Law, Man United and Scotland legend diagnosed with dementia. Scotland and Manchester United legend Dennis Law has been diagnosed with dementia. Law, 81, who says he has Alzheimer's and vascular dementia, is the latest former player to reveal he is suffering from the degenerative brain disease. His former United teammates Sir Bobby Charlton was diagnosed with the condition last year. Alongside Sir Bobby Charlton and George Best at Old Trafford, the striker formed what was hailed the United Trinity. Law, who started his career with Huddersfield Town, had two spells at Manchester City and played in Italy for Torino, won the European Cup, two English titles and the FA Cup in his 11 years at Old Trafford. Dennis Law will always be one of this club's greatest legends, and everybody at Manchester United sends our love and best wishes to him and his family, the club said. We know our fans around the world will also rally behind him. Law and his family are also fundraising for the Alzheimer's Society, who have offered the former footballer support. The charity is also doing amazing work with the sports industry, with its Sport United Against Dementia campaign, which I fully support, Law said. A study in 2019 found that professional footballers are 3.5 times more likely to die from dementia than people of the same age range in the general population. Sir Bobby was the fifth member of England's 1966 World Cup winning side to be diagnosed with dementia. His brother, Jack, and Nobby Styles, both died last year after suffering from brain functioning diseases believed to be linked closely to heading footballs, while both Martin Peters and Ray Wilson, who died in 2019 and 2018 respectively, also had the condition. In a BBC documentary screened in 2017, Styles' son John told former England captain Alan Shearer he was utterly convinced heading a football was responsible for his father's dementia. In 2014, a neuropathologist said that the death of former England and West Brom striker Jeff Astill was due to a brain condition caused by heading footballs. New guidelines limiting professional players in England to 10 higher force headers a week in training have been introduced this season. Astill's daughter Dawn has long pushed for research into a link between football and brain injuries, and worked with the Professional Footballers Association on an advisory basis to help shape the longer-term neurodegenerative care provision for former members and their families. Alzheimer's Society Chief Executive Kate Lee said she hoped Law's bravery in coming forward will encourage many others to seek the help they need. It's never been more important to fund crucial research and our vital support services and ensure that right now, past and present players, as well as fans, know our services are here and can get the dedicated dementia support they deserve, Lee continued. The Dennis Law Legacy Trust said it was saddened by the news. As a player, his grit and determination took him from the streets of Aberdeen to the pinnacle of world football, and everyone at the Trust knows he will use that same strength now to take on this illness, said the Trust's Chief Operating Officer, Mark Williams. The latest rumors and stories from around the world of football.